In this video lesson, we're going to cover the image element. Unlike setting the background image of another element like a section or a div block, an image element is its own element, an image we've dropped into the project. And of course, we can move it anywhere we want independent of other elements. We're going to cover four major sections here: adding images, replacing images, styling images, and alt attributes. Let's start with adding images to our project. A couple ways to do this. If we go to Add and look under our Elements panel, and we go down to Image and bring it into our project, we get a placeholder image. And Upload lets us do just that. We can upload an image, make our selection, and that's it. And anytime we bring in an image, we have the option to specify our own pixel values for width or height. We could also grab the corner of our image and drag. Of course, as we resize here, it won't get bigger than its parent element. We also have the HiDPI option. If we brought in an image that's 600 pixels wide, HiDPI will set the image element at half that, 300 pixels wide. This pixel density will ensure that the image looks great on HiDPI displays, like the MacBook Pro, or the Surface Book, or the Tamagotchi. Now, you're not required to do this. You don't have to specify values here at all. You can enter these as placeholder values, and you can always change them or override them over in the Element Style panel. We'll get to that in a moment. The other way to add images to our project is through the Asset Manager. And from there, we can choose a file and upload that right into our Asset Manager. We can grab it and drop it right into our project. So the Asset Manager is another way to add images into our project. What about replacing an image? Well, it's as simple as selecting an image. We can go up and press Show Settings, or we can simply double-click the image to do the same thing. And from there, we simply hit Replace Image. That's it. If we want to use an existing image, we can pull it from our Asset Manager. Or if we want to upload, we can do that here too. That's replacing an image. When it comes to styling images, we have access to most of the same options we have for other elements over in the Element Style panel. Of course, that means we can adjust the margin on our image, how much space it creates outside of its boundaries. It also means we can control size. Now, before we covered image settings, as you already know, we can control image settings regarding our size in here. But changes to size in the Element Style panel will override these settings. This is a huge time saver because we can apply the class to multiple images, like in this section. The same class is applied to each of these images. Changes we make to that class now affect all of these. And this is especially helpful to us because we can avoid having to manually set sizing for each and every image as we add it to the project. Now, in addition to all the other style properties we can control on an image element, a helpful one is controlling corner radius. We can set up rounding on one or more corners. We can also add other style attributes like drop shadow. Those adjustments will, of course, show up behind the boundary of our image. That's styling images. Finally, let's cover alt attributes. Regardless of how you brought in the image element, you can also access properties via the Element Settings panel. From here, we have those same controls and the ability to add an alt attribute. Generally, we want to write a brief description of the image we're seeing here. This is really helpful for accessibility and for search, like Google Images. So, we add image elements through the Elements panel or through the Asset Manager. We can replace an image by double-clicking on that image and pressing Replace Image. We can style images and create classes, which we can apply to other image elements. And from our Element Settings panel, we can add helpful alt attributes for accessibility and search. That's the image element.